Hey, Chris Liepe here for the Recording Revolution. Sometimes it's just best to learn from listening intently and in a certain way to really great music. And I'm really excited to be able to listen in a very specific way in this video to Wanna Be Startin Somethin, Michael Jackson. I have copies of the studio multitracks. Some of the vocals are summed, so we have stems, but I've got a lot of individual tracks that we get to go through. And so we're going to have a listening session, and we're going to pick apart some of these little nuances about Michael Jackson's performance vocally, about the instrumentation, the arrangement, the samples, the sounds used, the performance, the string performance and brass, all these things. We get to hear them isolated. This is a pretty rare thing. Thank you, friend in the music industry who is well-connected, who will remain unnamed. Having access to this level of depth in a song that I've been listening to for a really long time is quite the privilege. If you'd like more help with your own recording, you want to be inspired in the way that you lay down your bass tracks, create your drum loops, record your vocals, find your guitar tones, click the link below and join my free recording course. For now, let's get into this masterpiece, dive into these multi-tracks, and enjoy this song like we've never enjoyed it before. Quick overview, we've got the lead vocal. This is a comp. You can hear certain punches here and there, certain comps. We've got summed stereo backing vocals. This track called Little People, we'll find out what that is. Brass, real strings, and all sorts of programmed stuff. Got a real bass, we've got a synth bass. I think this kind of producing is as relevant today as it was back then, because we're doing so much with samples, so much with, you know, fake instruments or sampled instruments, and this is a top tier pop song, and a lot of what we're doing today harkens back to this style of production. So this is really, really cool to be able to see what's happened here. Yeah, we don't have all the MIDI and all that stuff, but we get to hear them in isolation. And one thing that I've noticed in listening through, because I have a couple other of these tracks as well, the sounds, it's all about the sum of the parts, right? The creative arranging that goes into this stuff. It's not necessarily about the quality of the single sample. I think sometimes we tend to overthink how something sounds. Just choose something and be creative with it. You can always change the sound later, starting from the top. We're going to solo out the lead vocals here at the beginning. I love this. You can hear his body moving in the background. You know, I heard that they used to mic Michael Jackson's feet. They used to put him on a pedestal and mic his feet and, you know, make sure that they picked up on the snaps. And he usually sang into a dynamic, usually an SM7B. And this captured the essence of his performance, having him multi-mic'd, having his body mic'd. And you can sort of hear that here at the beginning. Ooh.
I said you wanna be starting something, you got to be starting something. I said you wanna be starting something, you got to be starting something. How to get over, you're too low to get under, you're stuck.
You can hear the headphone bleed in there. Some of those background vocals were performed before he laid down his final take. That's pretty cool to know. Here's some background vocals here.
Starting something, starting something, starting something. Start us something.
Clean doubles.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So neat. Listening to how this brass interacts with these background vocals.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And I also found it compelling, these strings. They are real as real can be. Tuning and all. It helps with all the other synthetic elements of this track to have the realness of those strings. If those were also synthesized, it might be a little sterile. But having these real elements, real vocals, real strings, real claps, real guitar, this is great right here. Clap. Ah, so neat.
But nothing he found. By the time he's in the street, they said she had a breakdown. Someone's always trying, it's not my baby crying, talking, squealing, lying, saying.
So what's fun is to bring in certain elements as we're listening to the lead vocal and hear how they hug the lead vocal. Granted, a lot of the arranging was done and then he came in and sang, but you really get a sense for the holes that the arrangement is filling when you start bringing things in like this.
It's trying, it's not my baby crying, talking, squealing, lying, saying you just want to be starting something. I said you want to be starting something.
Let's go here.
Someone's always trying, it's not my baby crying, talking, squealing, lying, saying you just want to be starting something. I said you want to be starting something. You got to be starting something.
Now, I want to do a solo of the percussion. Just the percussion here for a minute. And you'll see, I mean, it's nothing special. We're going to leave the claps out for now. Listen to this. I mean, it's cool sounding. Any one of us can make a beat like that. With sounds, probably some of these same sounds. They've been not same exact ones, but there's plenty of resources out there to get sounds like this. It's about the writing and the arrangement. Super cool. Look at that snare sound. Now, these claps. These are real claps. And you can hear all the bleed in there. They added those after at least some of the lead vocals had been done. That's super cool. We got this bass. Actual played bass here, combined with this synth bass. Listen to the tuning discrepancies. That makes it more real. It stands up in the mix better. And this is just my own 2-minute faders up mix, which is, I think, cool to have not the real mix.
Not a reason that you're good when you're always up to...
This mono synth here. So it's cool because they've got that combined with the strings. You've got the perfection of the string, of the pad, that grounding with the volatility and neat human nature of the strings.
Always up to no good. You really can't make him hate her, so your tongue became a razor. Someone's always lying to keep my baby crying. Treacherous, cunning, declining. You got my baby crying. I said, wanna be starting something. You got to be starting something. Starting something.
That's cool.
Starting something. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Here are the strings.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's get rid of the bass. Put some claps in. Oh, here's Little People. Let's see what Little People is. Huh.
You're a vegetable. You're a vegetable.
How neat. Let's listen to that in context.
They hate you.
Right here. Wow. I never really, I mean, I suppose I sort of sensed them, but listen to the quality of these.
You're a vegetable.
Definitely sounds like there's some time compression expansion or interesting things going on, like digital sampling going on. I'm not sure exactly what that sound is. It sounds like to me like they've time compressed, expanded certain things or even changed the pitch. Maybe he sang it. That's probably what happened. He sang it in a different key and then they pitched it up.
You're a vegetable.
To get that little people type sound. Very interesting. Interesting that this power break, the guitar is on its own thing. And we've got that harmony part. Super cool. I want to hear that harmony in juxtaposition with just the kick and the bass, the regular bass, no synth bass. Ooh, and those cool toms. That's interesting. Listening to these guitars and how precise and accurate they are, yet how human they feel. I mean, there's some pick flubs, some subtle pick flubs in there. It's not about being exact. It's about being in the pocket and playing with the whole arrangement and the whole groove. And I mean, these musicians and programmers and producers here, there was nothing better for the time. They were amazing. But it's fun to hear the humanness of them when you isolate them. Don't even get me started on Michael Jackson's amazing natural sounding performances. I've done other videos like this that are more focused on his vocals. We're looking at the whole thing right now, but it's incredible to listen to some of these.
You'll be always trying to stop that job from crying, hustling, squealing, lying. Now, baby, slowly dying.
I say you wanna be starting something. You got to be starting something. I say you wanna be.
That's interesting. You can hear that comp together on this single track.
You got
right here.
Baby, slowly dying.
I say you wanna be starting something.
How it interrupts itself, like those were obviously recorded on different tracks, and these were summed to this one thing. I want to hear this real quick, though. Regular old snaps on mic.
Ow!
Yeah. Super cool.
Ooh!
Oh, the rawness of that. Let's hear that with the backing vocals.
Yeehaw!
Unsoloed.
Yeehaw!
Wow. Nice. All right.
You wanna be starting something? You got to be starting something. So you wanna be starting something? You got to be starting something. It's too high to get over. It's too low to get under.
Yeah, yeah.
You're stuck in the middle.
Yeah, yeah.
And the pain is thunder.
Yeah, yeah.
It's too high to get over.
Yeah, yeah.
You're too low to get under.
Ooh, Rose.
Yeah, yeah.
You're stuck in the middle.
Yeah, yeah.
And the pain is thunder.
Yeah, yeah.
Lift your head above and scream out to the world. I know I am someone. And let the truth unfurl. No one can hurt you now.
Huh.
Because you know it's true.
Hat.
Yes, I believe in me.
Hat too.
So you believe in you. Help me sing it.
This was compelling to me. I didn't really pick up on this so much. What I didn't pick up on initially was how incredibly robotic this feels. Now, it looks like when you look at these waveforms, you've got, they don't all look the same, right? On this hi-hat one. They look like they're performed. It's not like they just, you know, gritted something. That's not really how they rolled back then. But man, is it robotic sounding. Same thing here. Huh. Lots of little elements here. These toms. Some lots of gating going on there. End percussion. Ooh. That's neat. And the brass. Oh. You really get a sense for just like being in the studio, right? And having the producer solo thing. It's just so cool. Do there. Our own minimal ending. I hope you've enjoyed this deep dive into Wanna Be Startin Somethin. Michael Jackson, like I said, sometimes listening, active listening, dissecting while we're listening, observing, seeing how one part fits with another part, pulling those parts out and seeing how the arrangement exists without those, so that you get a justification for how the holes were filled and arranged so meticulously and creatively. Sometimes a dive like that is what we need to inspire us to create all sorts of other flavors in our own music. Again, if you'd like more help with that, click the link below and join my free recording course, and we can get you in the arranging creative mindset as well. We'll see you for more.